Come, they told me, ba-ra-ba-ba-ba. A newborn king to see, ba-ra-ba-ba-ba.
Our finest gifts we bring, ba-ra-ba-ba-ba.
Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Delicious things to eat.
The popcorn can't be beat. The sparkling drinks are just dandy. The chocolate bars and the candy. So let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us. Please take your seats, and we hope that you enjoy the feature presentation, Christmasplay, as presented by the Hazlehurst Church of God.
Man, these dogs are barking. While I'm here, I've got an interesting story to tell you.
He was sent to tell everyone about the light, so that through him they may believe. He was not the light, but he was sent to tell them about the light.
Many others have tried to give a report of the things that happened among us to complete God's plan. What they have written agrees with what we have learned from the people who saw these things and these events from the beginning. Then I decided to write it down for you in an organized way. I did this so that you can be sure that what you have been taught is true.
Greetings! My name is Zechariah, and I would like to tell you a story. It's about when that nasty old King Herod was still king over Israel, and I worked as a priest in the temple.
And I'm his wife. My name is Elizabeth, daughter of Aaron. And what a story this is.
Now they were both righteous before God. walking blamelessly in all the commandments and statutes of the Lord. But they had no child because Elizabeth was barren, and both were advanced in years.
I think you mean old, Mr. Narrator. Anyway, I was telling the story. Jeez. Let's see, where was I? Oh, yes. While I was serving as priest before God, I was on duty that day, and I was chosen to enter into the temple and burn incense.
All the people were praying outside during this time. And there appears to him an angel of the Lord standing by the altar. Zechariah was troubled. You could even say he was afraid when he saw the angel. But then the angel spoke and said,
"Do not be afraid."
Huh?
Do not be afraid.
Huh?
Don't be scared. He would stop interrupting me. Your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you shall call him John. He's going to get everybody ready for the coming of the Messiah.
But how can that be? I'm an old man. I mean, my wife old too.
I'm Gabriel, sent by God. And because you won't believe me, you won't be able to speak until it happens.
The people were waiting on Zechariah and wondering why it was taking him so long. And when he came out, he was unable to speak to them. And they realized that he had seen something in the temple. He tried to use signs, but remained mute. When his time of service ended, he went home. After that, his wife Elizabeth conceived, and for 5 months she kept herself hidden, saying,
"Look what God has done. He's been so good to me. Now people will stop thinking there's something wrong with me."
It's running after me. the goodness of God.
Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city in Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. Gabriel came to her house and said,
"Greetings, and do not be afraid."
What in the world?
Do not be.
Huh?
Do not be scared. Mary, you will bear a son, and his name will be Jesus, and his kingdom will have no end.
What? I'm a virgin. Seriously, I am.
The Holy Spirit will overshadow you, and the child will be called Holy, the Son of God. Because with God, nothing is impossible.
Behold, I am a servant of the Lord.
Mary arose and went with haste into the hill country to a town in Judah. She entered the house of Zechariah and Elizabeth. When Elizabeth saw Mary and heard her greeting, the baby in her womb leaped. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit, and she said boldly,
"Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the baby in your womb. And why am I so blessed that the mother of my Lord should come visit me?
My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices with God. He has looked upon his humble servant, and all generations shall call me blessed. He who is mighty has done a mighty thing for me."
When I heard your voice, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is the one that believes what God has said.
And holy is his name.
Thank you.
And Mary stayed with Elizabeth for about 3 months and then returned home. Now the time came for Elizabeth to give birth, and she bore a son. Her neighbors and relatives heard that the Lord showed her great mercy, and they rejoiced with her. On the eighth day, they came and circumcised the child. They were about to call him Zechariah after his father, but his mother answered,
"No, his name is John."
"But none of the other relatives are named this." Then all the guests looked to Zechariah to ask him what he thought the boy's name should be. So he wrote it on a tablet. "His name is John." And immediately his mouth was opened and his tongue loosened, and he spoke, blessing God. All these things were talked about through all the hill country of Judea. And all who heard were amazed. They wondered who this child would be because the hand of the Lord was with him. His father Zechariah was filled with the Spirit and prophesied, saying,
"Blessed be the Lord God of Israel. He has visited and redeemed his people, and you shall be a prophet of the Most High. You shall go before him and prepare his way, and he shall be the light unto the people."
And then his child grew and became strong in spirit, and he was in the wilderness until it publicly appeared in Israel. Now the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. But Joseph, being a just man and not wanting to put her to shame, wanted to keep things quiet.
"Wait, she's pregnant? We ain't even married yet. Well, I guess now I just gotta break up with her in secret, send her away. That's the only respectful thing to do."
But just as Joseph was thinking these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying,
"Joseph, do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for the baby is conceived of God. You will call his name Jesus, and he will save people from their sins."
All this happened in order to fulfill what had been spoken by the prophet.
"Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us."
When Joseph woke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife, but he knew her not until she had given birth to a son. And he called his name Jesus.
Come.
those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken in the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register.
I'm going to leave Nazareth, and I'm going to go back to the city of Bethlehem, the city of David, because we're descendants of David.
We gotta go. We're
pepper spray? Thank you. Hello? Thank you. Come again.
Can I help you? We have no rooms.
Is there anything you can do
now? I'm in charge of this. Is there anything you can do right now? Because she's huge!
Are you platinum members?
These robes.
You said platinum?
No, we're not platinum.
You can go to the stables. Maybe they can help you.
Are you sure?
And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger.
Because they weren't platinum members?
And in the same region, there were shepherds out in the field watching their flock at night.
No way, this is my stick.
No way, man.
No, it's my stick. It's your own.
I ripped it out of the tree myself.
I stole it from you.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
Go on,
I don't want that stick.
Give me this.
An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them.
Look at all those chickens.
What is that?
It's a ghost.
Do not be afraid.
Huh?
Don't even. Just listen. I bring to you good news of great joy for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, Christ the Lord. You will find him wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
We're gonna find out what's happening!
This is gonna be huge!
And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God, saying,
joyful.
They looked into the night sky, and behold, a new star. It was strangely bright and was out of position from any constellation. The shepherds wondered amongst themselves and were interrupted.
Hey guys, follow me. I know the way.
Is that a talking star?
Dude, this is getting better and better.
Can I touch it?
No.
And they went with haste to Bethlehem.
Is that as fast as you can get? You got to speed this up. We got to hurry.
Welcome to Omar's Merchant Emporium. May I interest you in some fine antiquities?
Don't get distracted. We got to hurry.
Thank you. Come again.
Okay, hurry up, you guys. We're almost there. We've got to hurry. We're just around the corner.
And they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. In amazement, the three shepherds looked on as they witnessed baby Jesus.
This is it. He is risen.
Duh, that's what she said.
I told y'all so.
Can I touch you?
And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child, and all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them.
Hello?
The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as the angel of the Lord exclaimed, and they all celebrated.
Yahoo!
Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem.
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts we traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star.
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts we traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceed, to thy perfect light.
Born a king on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again. King forever, ceasing never, over us all to reign.
Frankincense to
behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem. When they had reached the city of Jerusalem, they began searching.
Hello, can anyone tell us where this baby king is?
Yes, exactly. We've been following this talking star forever.
This little dude has a talking star as a lighthouse.
Little birdie, go master king.
No crap.
Thank you.
Always good to be king. More! What?
There are three kings in your realm in search for the child king whose birth has been foretold.
How dare they insult my awesomeness! Find them and bring them to me. They must pay for this grand offense. My lord!
Greetings, gentlemen. You are looking to be cold. Perhaps I can interest you in this sheepskin linen, now with 30% added underlayment. Act now and you receive a free ferrule.
Hey, you three!
Tax collectors!
I see you one more!
Away with you, you swine!
You have been summoned by the king.
That's what we're trying to do.
Exactly, we're trying to see the baby king.
Exactly! No! Not the baby one, the buff king, the King Herod.
Who keeps eating my little Debbies? You put the wrapper back in the box! Ruin my entire night!
Bethlehem of Judea, as it is written by the prophets.
And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who will shepherd many people, Israel.
And after listening to the king, they went on their way, and behold, the star that they had seen when it rose went before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child.
Gold for the baby king.
Frankincense for his lordship.
Myrrh for his sovereignty.
And they fell down and worshipped him. After this, they took camp for the night just outside the region of the stables. An angel of the Lord warned them not to return to Herod, and they departed to their own country by another way. After 8 days, he was circumcised, and they called his name Jesus, the name given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. Mary took up the baby Jesus and entered the temple, and they offered a sacrifice as it was written in the law of the Lord.
Every male who first opens the womb shall be called holy to the Lord. He shall receive a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons.
Thank you.
Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon, and this man was righteous and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him.
A long time ago, God told me that I would never die until I'd laid eyes upon the Messiah. How much longer did I have to wait?
And Simeon came in the Spirit into the temple. And when Mary and Joseph brought in the child Jesus in accordance with the custom of the law, Simeon took the baby Jesus up in his arms and blessed God, saying,
I can now die in peace, for I have seen the salvation of the Lord.
Now, there was in the temple a prophetess, Anna, who was the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher.
I'm always in this temple. I never leave because I worship God day and night. Blessed am I, for my eyes have seen the Christ child.
After this, Simeon gave the child Jesus back to his mother and departed. After these things, Joseph, Mary, and the baby Jesus returned to the stable for the night.
hides his face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory.
Joseph slept in the stable. The angel of the Lord appeared once again to him in a dream and said,
"Rise and take them to Egypt until I tell you, because Herod is trying to kill them."
So Joseph took Mary and Jesus and left that night. They traveled to Egypt so they could escape King Herod's evil plan. This happened so the prophecy would be fulfilled.
"Out of Egypt I called my son."
Then Herod, when he saw that he had been tricked by the wise kings, he became furious.
"Cannot believe they tried to double cross me. They will pay for this treachery. Guards! Go out and kill all the Israelite sons, 2 years in them. They will learn never to try to make a fool of me again."
This horrible thing took place so that another prophecy would be fulfilled, Prophet Jeremiah said.
"There was bitter crying and great sadness in Ramah. Rachel cries for her children, and you cannot make her happy because of all the children are gone."
Truly, it was a sad day in the land. Nasty old King Herod did terrible things, but it wasn't long after this that Herod, that mean old king, dropped dead. And after these things, the angel of the Lord appeared unto Joseph again in a dream while they were in Egypt, and said,
"Return to Israel and don't worry. Herod is dead."
When they had performed everything according to the law of the Lord, they returned to Nazareth, which is in the land of Galilee. And then Jesus grew and became strong and filled with wisdom. God's favor was upon him because he was the Son of God, the Savior of man, King of kings, Lord of lords, Jesus Christ.
Well, folks, thank you for hearing me out. I hope the story blessed you as much as it has blessed me. Because I was once blind, and now I see. This Damascus Road has set me free. Well, I need to get back on the road from Damascus. So may God bless you, and Merry Christmas.
Sure.